So the air canal, we had the open-close system. And in this case, this pipe is closed at both ends. So we call this the close-close system. And just to complete the discussion here, the last combination is your open-open system. So I'll just show these side by side. And you'll notice that the close-close and the open-open ends up being quite similar. How does that work? Well, in the close-close system, you need no displacement or nodes in the two ends. Whereas for an open-open system, you need anti-nodes or the maximum displacement at the two ends. So the pattern that fits here, it's one of these humps. Whereas for the open-open system, you have basically two half humps, right? Because it has to be maximum on this side and maximum on this side. As a result, the length here is half the wavelength. Then the next mode, or what we call the first overtone, you have these kind of patterns, which this is one wavelength, right? It takes two humps to make one wavelength. And this is also one wavelength. And then again, they want the first three modes, so let's put that in here as well. Basically, you're seeing here is that the open-open and the close-close has the same pattern in terms of how the length relates to the wavelength, and therefore has certain statements about the frequencies. The pipe being 3 meters, that makes the first wavelength 6 meters, 3 meters, and 2 meters. Knowing what my speed is, that tells us then my frequency is that, which you can see, again, we have the second harmonic and the third harmonic for my first and second overtones. A lot of words that kind of mean similar things, but it's really not that complicated, hopefully. But the bigger picture here is, based on these standing waves and resonance, we can predict for a particular length of pipe, given the speed of sound, we can then predict what note that pipe would play in an organ. And this is the basic working principle of many musical instruments, where we change the length of either a tube of air, a pipe, or a vibrating string. In all cases, we're making use of this standing wave because, again, the standing wave has this property where the system only responds strongly for a particular frequency. So we can produce sound at a specific frequency, which is what we want in a musical instrument.